Okay, so happy endings. In rasa, generally speaking, a happy ending is rasa. If you think about a film, a love story, where is the rasa? The rasa is that moment when the lovers are finally united after overcoming so many trials and tribulations. Finally, they can have that kiss on the railroad platform or in the plane, in the airport or somewhere by the river Seine or something. You know, you have that beautiful scene where finally the lovers are united and you know that that's the end of the film. Well, Jiva Goswami wants a happy ending for Radha and Krishna. And actually, the way that Rupa Goswami has explained things in Ujjala Nilamani and in his other books, you can see that he also intended that there should be a happy ending to Radha and Krishna's lila. The prakata-lila, the separation, Jiva Rupa Goswami says so many times in all of his major books, in the Padyavali, in Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, in Ujjala Nilamani, in Laghu Bhagavatamrita, in each of these texts, Rupa Goswami has specified that the prakata-lila, the lila work that takes place in this world, Krishna's avatar lila, where there is separation, Radha and Krishna are separated, that only takes place in the material manifestation. It doesn't take place in the real Krishna lila. It doesn't take place in the eternal Krishna lila. It doesn't take place in the Nitya Krishna lila, because Krishna is never separated from his dearest devotees. How is that possible? Jiva Goswami asks that question. He says, the gopis have invested everything in Krishna. At the very end, in Kurukshetra, Krishna says one verse that Jiva Goswami finds to be very important. Huh? He says, Mayibhya bhaktirhi bhutanam angitam thaya kalpate dishayanasi patsneho bhavatina madapunaha. So he says that bhakti is such a thing, as we said in the other class the other day. He says bhakti revainam nayati, bhakti revainam darshanati, bhakti pashat purusha bhakti revabhuyasi. He said that Krishna is subjected to bhakti, that Krishna is dependent on bhakti, that bhakti is actually even greater than Krishna. So if bhakti is greater than Krishna, then how can Krishna escape the gopis? How can he leave the gopis? How can he leave Vrindavan? Mahaprabhu said to Rupa Goswami when he was trying to conduct the Madhava and Lalita Madhava, he said, don't you know? You've taken Krishna out of Vrindavan. That's not allowed. He says, that Krishna never leaves Vrindavan. Vrindavanam prityaja padamekam na gacchati. He never takes even a step outside of Vrindavan. How can you take Krishna out of Vrindavan? That's the nitya state. Krishna is always with his gopis. The gopis have conquered him. They've conquered him with their love. And their love is more powerful. Krishna is subjected to their love. He can't abandon them. He can't leave them. And he says it himself there in the Bhagavatam in Kurukshetra. He says, Mayi bhaktirhi bhutanam amritatvaya kalpate. That the bhakti, devotion to me, brings you immortality. You are most fortunate because by the grace of God, by good fortune, by whatever destiny you have, you attain this love for me. And that love for me is madhapana. Attains me. You get me. You get me. I can't go anywhere else. I have to be with you. So even though in the Bhagavatam it appears that Krishna has left the gopis, he promises again and again that I'm coming back. He writes letters, he says, don't worry, I'm coming back. He says to Nanda Maharaj and Mother Yashoda, he says, don't worry, I'm coming back. Only a few more days. I have a few more demons to kill. I have a little bit more duty to perform. And once it's done, then I'll come back. And we know, if Krishna is anything, he's the absolute truth. At the very beginning of the Bhagavad And the demigods came and they prayed to Krishna and they said, you know, satyasya satyam nihite cha satyam nihitam cha satye. You are the truth, you are the truth, you are the truth. Satyapakam tvam sharanam prapadye. You are the essence of truth. Now, satya sankalpa, that's Krishna. Well, if Krishna promises to return, then he must return. But the Bhagavatam doesn't give us that joy. The Bhagavatam doesn't give us that happiness. Bhagavatam doesn't give us that pleasure. And Bhagavatam leaves us hanging with the gopis so far away from Krishna and so disappointed, saying, how can we live without you? So, in the 71st chapter of the 10th canto, Sanatana Goswami, in his commentary, points out that Dantavakra, this is already the 71st chapter of the Bhagavad, the 10th canto, it's almost the end. And in that 71st chapter, Krishna fights and defeats and kills Shalva and then Dantavakra, two of the remaining demons. And after that, it says that in that particular lila, it says that Krishna was actually near Mathura when he killed Dantavakra. That battle took place somewhere in the vicinity of Mathura, somewhere in the vicinity of the Yamuna. So when Krishna had finished and had destroyed the Dantavakra demon, according to a text found in the Padma Purana, which Jiva gives great importance to and which Sanatana Goswami gives great importance to, Krishna took off his weapons, he put down his conch shell, he crossed the Jamuna, he took on his gopavesh, he took his flute, and he entered triumphantly back into the village of the cowherds and was reunited with the Brajavasis. And they gave up their suffering and separation and were joined in the great delight of meeting Krishna again. And that, according to Rupa Goswami, that is called Samritiman Sambhog. That is the greatest joy of reunion. So, Jiva Goswami wants to retell the Bhagavata story in order to make that explicit. What was implicit in the Bhagavatam becomes explicit in the Gopala-champu. And I'd like to go on with this and tell a little bit more, and we'll do that in the next video.